So a change in High Sierra is how Safari deals with preferences. So let's look first at Sierra. So this is how it used to work, or if you're still using Sierra, this is how it works for you. Under Preferences in Safari, for instance in Security, you can set plugin settings, say for Flash Player, for individual websites. You can see the ones you're viewing currently, and you can turn it to Ask or On or Off, and you can set it for a default for others. You can also set things across all of the web for any website you visit. But it works differently now in High Sierra. And High Sierra gives a lot more options, including the ability to control automatic playback of video. So here in High Sierra, Safari looks a little different. If we go to Security, we can see fewer options. Same thing with Privacy. But we have a new section here called Websites. And everything for all different websites is combined here. So you can, for instance, go to Autoplay. And this determines whether or not video autoplays when you go to a page on that site. And you can see here for the two sites I've got open here in two tabs, it shows Stop Media with Sound, Allow All Autoplay, or Never Autoplay. And I can set that for the websites that are visible, and it will remember that. So every time I go back to the website, it's going to use that setting. For all other websites, I can set it to a default. Then I have these other options as well. For instance, I can go to Reader and say, yes, I always want to automatically switch to the Reader view. I can go to Content Blockers. If I have something installed like an ad blocker, I can set it up for, yes, always use it on this site, don't use it on this other site. Even things like how much to zoom in on the pages are remembered. Camera settings, microphone settings, whether or not your location is shared, whether or not notifications are allowed, and then any plugins like Flash or Shockwave down here. So it's just one section here in High Sierra where I can define everything on a per website basis. In particular, a lot of people are going to be interested in that video autoplay setting. So here I am back in Sierra. I'm going to go to a page that I've created where I've set the video to autoplay. And you can see the video starts playing right away with sound and everything on that page. Now, if I go over to High Sierra and I go to that same page, you can see the video loads, but it doesn't autoplay. If I go to Preferences here, you can see for autoplay, there's the site that I'm testing, and it's set to Stop Media with Sound. I can set it to say Allow Autoplay, and now when I reload this page, it will autoplay as before. Let's look at another setting. Let's look at the Reader setting. So let's go to Wikipedia and let's just pick a random article. And you can see I can go into Reader View for this article and I can exit. But I could also go to Preferences under Websites under Reader and I could set Wikipedia to always go to Reader View. So now you can see it automatically does that there. Let's go back to the main Wikipedia page and search for something else. And you can see it jumps to that page and automatically goes into Reader View. So let's say we'll turn that off and let's try the page zoom. And we could say we always want Wikipedia to be zoomed in to 125. And now it'll always do that for Wikipedia. So we can close this tab here, open another tab, go to Wikipedia and search for something there. And you can see it zoomed in at 125 there. So it's always going to do it for this website. So if there's a site that you visit where the text is just too small for you all the time, you can set it up like that and not worry about it again.